Okay, this flow that you were watching that they were doing, there's a couple of things that you have to take into account. We're working the high wing block off of that. So high wing is if you take your stick and you've got it down in the ground and you have to pull it up. That's where the high wing comes into play. It's efficient. It's taking, even from this extension, going from here to a high wing is much more efficient than going from here to a roof block. And what is that? You might say, why is that? If you look at the travel of the tip, it's just like anything else. Whenever we have something that has a lot more travel, that means more time to either get to the target or to get to a defensive position, that sort of thing. So we want to make sure that if I'm going from here, we look at this travel, it's already in position much quicker than for me to go from this to here. A lot more travel, a lot more things can interfere with it on the way to that defensive position. So that's one of the keys. The other thing is when you're testing this, she has to hit my stick on a high wing just to make sure I don't get this rebound effect. And the rebound effect is this coming back and hitting myself because I'm either too loose on the wrist or I'm not used to getting hit hard. So on training, she's gonna whack that a bit so that I get used to it. And she's gonna go towards the third end of the stick. There we go, because that's gonna get me, yeah. That means I have to work more control. So in here, if I'm walking through, bam, yeah, I gotta get used to that. And it's all done on movement, so I'm getting used to that in general, okay? The roof block is the same way. If I go through here, how much force do I have to put on this by pushing into the hit? Now, this particular one that we work, if you come through here, just do that flow a bit. I'm going to point out what they're using. Yeah, nice and slow. So we're working a thrust and a shield defense. Then we go to the high wing defense. And that high wing defense is really the key there. So now she basically is going to work clearing the tool. She's starting to change to another range. And then she attacks. So we go back through the cycle. Stab, high wing, clear the tool, and return a stab. Okay, so on this movement, the defense off of that straight line that we're using right now, and there are a lot of them, this is just something so that you can get used to a flow. There's a lot going into this, so there's a reason why I'm having students train this. And right now, this shield defense, it has to have your hands in a location to where you can come back in here and change range. So I can go here, I can start working this off this line, but then still have this protecting my heart and my throat. I have to have my rear hand defense in play. Off of that thrust, if I just stay here and hope that I can get this in time, I'm a goner, okay? Because sometimes that will happen much faster than I can get in there. So I have to be able to move. And what I do is I move on the diagonal toward her. Now, because we're trying to keep a flow going. If I'm just trying to get out of the way of a machete coming at me, and there are machete fights, just so you understand, this is not just imaginary. And you also have to remember, what we're doing here is directly related to knife training. So the foundational skills you build up from here directly translate to knife. So off of this, I may also be out here. I may be doing it just to clear space and go backwards at a diagonal instead of forwards. Now for the flow, I'm going to go forwards right in here. And I may come over the top like that, and that's where we get into that mode. So if I'm going through here, it's the same thing. I'm hitting on top of the head. She's got to get used to that force. She's got to get used to that hit. And then later when you train to rattan sticks, it's the same mentality. So I am going to hit her head. She has to change her position to me or she gets hit in the head. That's my goal, hit her head, bam. She is changing, advancing on me, and that changes the whole mechanic. Same thing here, yeah. So that defense goes right to here, okay? So when she comes back in here and does that again, So as she does that, you can see now, she captures the hand. And the reason she captures this hand is she's going to have the option. Later on, we're going to be breaking that tool hold. We're going to be able to remove the tool, that sort of thing. Or we're going to be able to redirect the knife. So when she's got her hand up in there and she's doing that right there, she is now clearing the path. So she has to clear it forward of her own body. So she can't just clear it straight down because she'll hit her own leg. Later on, this is important when we get to the knife. And as we get to the knife, she may actually switch out leg positions, that sort of thing. So when she comes back to that again, through there and there, brings that down and clears the tool so she can get in there. Now off of this strike, when she comes over the top like that, yep, she's now already using peripheral skills to pick up that motion. Notice how she's shifting her head off to the side. She's getting out of the way because she's going to start in a progression diagonal forward here. So she has to clear her own leg, yes, and then come back in for this thrust, okay, or a stab at that particular time. So one more time, if you just go nice and slow, nice and relaxed. So a lot of this is movement. You have to be moving on this. You have to adapt to your partner's thrusting. You have to adapt to their striking over the top. And you have to adapt to clearing not only the tool, but your body out of the way of the tool. Okay. Okay, good time. So when we're coming through here and I'm defending here, this can also be the butt end of the stick or the knife. If I really wanted to change range and I'm coming in through here, maybe I'm just working to do the butt end of that and work that strike or clear through here. And later on, this becomes more apparent what we're doing when we have a knife in play. And again, a lot of my knife stuff has to go onto Patreon. So it's patreon.com/CoreJKD, even a dollar a month will get you some of that, because there's stuff that I just can't show because they will demonetize it here on YouTube, so I won't show the knife work here, but I will be showing it there. So once we get through here, clear this, this becomes apparent when we start having a blade in the hand. Now these clearing methods become much more effective and prevalent at that time. So in here, when I'm smacking this, this is a, typically what they'll have is they'll have a skullcracker end on it. You don't see as many of them now, but what that does is a conical shape that actually on impact will split the skull, the actual bone beneath the skin. So there's a lot of history in how this stuff works and why it works well. So this is just something to get you used to footwork and that sort of thing. And we're gonna show you their footwork here in a second. So you can see that dynamic moving to the side, moving forward. All of those are at diagonals. So a lot of that is clearing the weapon range, making sure they can evade properly, lunging into position properly, as well as lunging out of range properly.